In this video, we are going to study about the placenta. All eukaryotic mammals possess placenta. Human placenta is a discoid choriodeciduate organ which connects the fetus with the uterine wall of the mother. It is a structure where maternal and the fetal tissues come in direct contact without a rejection, suggesting immunological acceptance of the fetal graft by the mother. So when you see the gross anatomy, at the full term, the placenta is disc-like and presents after separation from the uterine wall two surfaces. One is the fetal surface, the other one is the maternal surface, and you have the peripheral margin. So this is the peripheral margin. So when you see the fetal surface, so this is the fetal surface. The fetal surface is smooth and it is covered by the amnion and presents the attachment of the umbilical cord. So this is the umbilical cord. The umbilical cord is attached to the fetal surface close to its center. Beneath the amnion, you have the umbilical vessels which radiate from the cord, and sometimes you have the extra embryonic part of the yolk sac, which is known as the umbilical vesicle, is also found beneath the fetal surface close to the umbilical cord, and it is connected by a fibrous remnant of the vitrello-intestinal duct. And this is the maternal surface. When you see the maternal surface, it is rough and irregular, and it is mapped out into 15 to 30 polygonal areas which are known as the cotyledons. And these cotyledons are limited by the fissures. So these are the fissures, and each fissure is occupied by the placental septum. And next we'll see the peripheral margin. So the outer margin is the peripheral margin. It is continuous with the fetal membrane, which consists from outside inwards. You have fused decidua parietalis and capsularis. Then you have the chorion levae and amnion. So this is a diagrammatic representation. So this is the fetal surface of the placenta, which is smooth, and it has the umbilical cord which is attached close to its center, and beneath that you have this amnion, the fetal membrane, and beneath the amnion you have the umbilical vessels which radiate from the cord. Sometimes you have the extra embryonic part of the yolk sac, which is known as the umbilical vesicle. It is found beneath the fetal surface close to the umbilical cord, and it is connected by a fibrous remnant of the vitrello-intestinal duct. And this is the maternal surface, which is rough and irregular, and it is mapped out into cotyledons, raised areas which are known as cotyledons, limited by the fissures, and this fissure is occupied by the placental septum, and this is the peripheral margin. Next we'll see the measurement. At full term, the placenta presents the following measurements. The diameter is about 15 to 20 centimeter, and the thickness 3 centimeter at the center, and it weighs about 500 grams. So the proportional weight between the placenta and the fetus at various stages of pregnancy are: in the first month, the proportional weight between the placenta and the fetus is 6:1, whereas in the fourth month, the proportional weight is the placenta and the fetus is 1:1. At birth, the proportional weight of the placenta and the fetus is 1:7. A full-term placenta occupies about 30% of the uterine wall. Next we'll see the structure of the placenta. The placenta consists of the chorionic plate on the fetal side, and the basal plate on the maternal side, and then you have the stem villi which extends between the chorionic plate and the basal plate, and then you have the intervillar space. Between the stem villi you have the intervillar space which is filled with the maternal blood. The chorionic plate is covered by the amniotic membrane, and it is composed of following structure from within outwards. From fetus to the mother side you have the primary mesoderm. So the black one is the gray one is the primary mesoderm. Then you have the cytotrophoblast, and then you have the syncytiotrophoblast. So the chorionic plate consists of from within outward, from fetus to mother. You have the primary mesoderm containing the branches of the umbilical vessels, that is the fetal vessels. Then you have the cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. And this is the basal plate which consists from outside inward, from mother fetal side. You have the stratum spongiosum of the decidua basalis containing the maternal blood vessels. Then you have the outer layer of the syncytiotrophoblast, which is known as the Knitterbux layer, which undergoes fibrinoid degeneration. Then you have the outer shell of the cytotrophoblast, and then you have the inner layer of the syncytiotrophoblast. The outer zone of this layer also undergo fibrinoid degeneration, and it is known as the Rohr's fibrinoid stria. The basal plate is perforated by the spiral branches of the uterine artery and the vein. Eventually, the intervillar spaces is filled with the maternal blood. Numerous placental septa project from the basal plate into the intervillar space, but they fail to reach the chorionic plate. Each placental septum consists of a central core of decidua basalis containing the decidual cells. Then you have the remnants of the endometrial glands and some maternal vessels, and it is covered by the cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. The area between the adjacent placental septa are known as the cotyledons, which are absorbed from the detached maternal surface. Each cotyledon presents a central axis of one or more stem villi, and then you have isolated and multinucleated giant cells which are derived from the fetal syncytiotrophoblast, which are found in the decidua basalis of the basal plate. These giant cells are believed to secrete the placental hormones. The stem villi connects the chorionic and the basal plate. It consists of primary, secondary and tertiary villi with the progress of development. So this is the primary villi. In the primary villi you have the central core of cytotrophoblast, and it is covered by the cells of the syncytiotrophoblast. The central core of cytotrophoblast covered by syncytiotrophoblast. So this is the primary villi, and this is the secondary villi. In the secondary villus, it consists of central core of the primary mesoderm. This is the gray color one is the primary mesoderm, and it is covered successively by the cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. So this is the secondary villi, which has a central core of primary mesoderm covered by cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. And this is the tertiary villi. The tertiary villus consists of a central fetal blood vessel which is surrounded successively from within outward by the primary mesoderm, the cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. From each tertiary stem villus, numerous branching villi project into the intervillar space. the branching villi, they may fuse with the adjacent villi and with the outer and the inner walls of the intervillar space. Therefore, the intervillar space is converted into a sponge-like network of villus type of labyrinthine structure, and it is filled with the maternal blood. The blood vessels within the branching villi, they do not anastomose with the neighboring ones. The branching or the terminal villi or the functional unit of the placenta. Each terminal villus is covered by two layers of cytotrophoblastic epithelium, that is the inner cytotrophoblast resting on the basement membrane and outer syncytiotrophoblast. The central core of the villus contains 1 to 6 fetal capillaries and the stromal cells. The stroma consists of primitive mesenchymal cells, fibroblast, collagen fibers, some phagocytic and reniform half-Bayer cells. The syncytial buds invaginate from the trophoblast and they project into the villus stroma. In early part of pregnancy, about 800 to 1000 stem villi radiate from the entire chorionic wall. Later, with the regression of the chorion leeway, only 60 stem villi persist in human placenta. Since the number of the maternal cotyledon is 15 to 30, it is suggested that each cotyledon contains 2 to 4 major stem villi. A major stem villus and the vessels derived from it forms the fetal cotyledon. The compartment of the intervillar space are not watertight and they communicate with one another around the stem villi. The space is lined internally by the syncytiotrophoblast and is filled with the maternal blood, which does not communicate directly with the fetal blood. About 500 ml of maternal blood circulate through the intervillar space per minute. Since the volume of the intervillar space is about 140 ml, the blood within the space is exchanged about 4 times per minute. Next, we'll see the placental barrier. The placental barrier consists of tissue which intervenes between the fetal blood in the chorionic villi and the maternal blood in the intervillar space. Through this barrier, exchange of gaseous and metabolic product takes place between the fetus and the mother. Up to the third month of pregnancy, the barrier consists of following 4 layers. From fetus to mother, you have the endothelium of the fetal capillary resting on the basement membrane. Then you have the core of the primary mesodermal cells. And then you have the basement membrane upon which rest cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. From the fourth month onwards, the barrier is practically reduced to 2 layers. The endothelium of the fetal capillary resting on the basement membrane, and then you have the syncytiotrophoblast, which presents a numerous microvilli in the intervillar space, increasing the total surface area of 14 square meters at full term. In some areas of the terminal villi, the syncytium fuses with the stromal capillary wall, forming the vasculosyncytial membrane. The membranous area are known as alpha zones, which are the sites of materno-fetal exchanges. Rest of the area of the terminal villi are non-membranous, and these are known as the beta zones, where the stromal cells and the cytotrophoblast persist. The beta zones are the sole function of hormone synthesis. Therefore, the human placenta is a discoid, deciduate, hemochorial and villus type of labyrinthine organ.